I said we got a whole show lined up. You're on Spiritual Sense with Shay WVLM. Now, I told you guys that today we have another interview with Shanisha Taylor, and so I would like to welcome her. Shanisha, are you there?
I am here. Thank you very much.
You're very, very welcome. And if you could just turn up your speaker or your mic a little bit, because it's a little low. But welcome back. Let me say what's been happening, at least according to the news reports. Shanisha has, had her court date, and apparently the news is saying that she has squandered her money, that there's no money left for anything, and they want to actually reinstate the felony charges against her. She offered to make a certain amount as far as putting it into the children's trust fund, and they did not like the idea, or she didn't stick to her plea agreement. Something transpired, and so we have her on the line to basically set the record straight, because there has been a lot of negative energy concerning what's been happening with her case. And we know that over 4,000 people have donated money, and so some people are saying, what has happened to the money. And we know the young lady that set up the account, Amanda Bishop, has spoken out. Nothing too negative, but you could see that she's kind of on the fence with what she now believes, or something like that. So we wanted to get Shanisha on the line and let her explain what's been happening, and just basically set the record straight as to what has transpired, because the media has a way of only putting out what they want to put out without asking the necessary questions, or they may even know the answer to the questions, but controversy sells. So that's what it's all about. So Shanisha, you can pick it up wherever you like. There's a lot to tackle, so wherever you want to pick it up, you can do that.
I would definitely say the media is playing a part in this particular case.
Sure.
You're correct. They haven't bothered to ask me any questions. They haven't bothered to clarify any information. And, for the record, no, the money is not gone. The money is sitting in my account waiting for the terms to be something that's a little bit more agreeable and something that's going to provide for my children, not just in the future, but for tomorrow.
Sure.
Which, that was my problem. It's not necessarily that I went against the plea deal. I had concerns with the plea deal, and I expressed those concerns to my attorney for months. Mm-hmm. And those concerns were ignored. They were, looked over. They weren't addressed. Mm-hmm. And finally, it came down to the judge saying, this is the date that I want it done by, and asking me, will you take care of this? And my response was, I will work with my attorney, because in my opinion, that's what I was supposed to do in that particular situation, work with my attorney to get these terms to something that I know is going to be able to take care of the children. That was the whole point of this whole thing, is to be able to take care of my children. Mm-hmm. And if I can't do that, then it's not doing what it was set up to do. So that was my concern, and that, what I tried to address, and it went crazy. It went bad from there.
Okay. Now, there was $60,000 that was supposed to be set up, right? 34 education, 34 childcare. Yes. And so in the news, they're saying that you offered to do 35 instead of the 60. Is that true? And what was the reason for that?
The reason for that is the news is actually reporting a negotiation that was handling between myself and the state.
I see.
It was an offer simply because when your top point is $60,000 and you offer $35,000, somewhere in the middle of that is going to be where the agreed amount comes in. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't an offer of $35,000 saying this is all I have, this is what I would do. It was simply opening up the negotiations to say, this is where we can start. This is my low point. Meet me somewhere in the middle.
Okay. And then what is this? Because I heard something about the 31st. You would be able to do the $35,000 on the 31st, or whatever the negotiation would. It would be, you would be able to do it on December 31st versus now?
That was the agreed upon date. If they were going to push for the full $60,000, I just simply asked for them to give me until December to be able to do that. My whole goal is to get back to work and to get my family financially stable so that it's no longer a struggle. It's not, how am I going to pay the lights? How am I going to pay the rent? How am I going to buy the food? I don't want that worry anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And that's basically handing over $60,000 now with no source of income coming in, no job on the horizon, finding out that I'm going to be tied up in court for the next 6 months to a year, I have to make sure that financially I can take care of them. That's my concern with this whole thing.
And so they don't get that part, like, and you, 'cause you mentioned something about your attorney was supposed to address this, but did that not happen?
That apparently never happened. I'm finding out that they were requesting information that was never that was never told to me. They were asking questions, they were getting inquiries that were never that was never asked of me. So it kind of became a communication breakdown between me and my attorney, where I didn't know half of what was going on because he's not telling me. He's not letting me know this is what they want, this is what they need. He's telling me the good stuff. Oh, well, we've got this going on. That's great. Tell me the bad stuff too, so I can be aware of the situation.
Great. And so, and I'm sorry, because I use the word great a lot. I don't mean great as in terms of this is great. It's just
No,
something
nothing
that I
about this is
say. I'm
great.
sorry. Because I was listening back to our other interview when we were talking about your children. I had said great. And when I listened back, I'm like, I didn't mean great. So please excuse me. That's just one of the things that I say. But okay, so then where does things stand with your attorney? Why wouldn't he give you the information that's needed?
That is a question that I cannot answer for you. Basically, the communication breakdown between he and I came to the point where I just had to retain a new attorney because I need somebody who's going to stand up for me in this situation. I understand that this is going to make his career. I understand that he's going to get, some major kudo points from this. You negotiated something great for somebody, but at the end of the day, we're still in this. We are still fighting for my life. So I need you to be committed to right now, not what's going to happen after this.
And they said that the attorney that you had was working pro bono. Was there any truth to that?
That attorney was pro bono, but keep in mind, I have two other attorneys. There's a lot going on in this particular case. It's not just one case. It was like two cases going on at one time. Plus, I needed a trust attorney. So, that particular attorney was pro bono, but I have two other attorneys to maintain.
See, that's something that the media didn't know.
Right.
That helps people to
Right.
understand because
Right.
who knew that, when they said, okay, this attorney is free, everybody, antennas kind of went up. Well, if that was free, why does
Exactly.
she have legal fees? But you
Right.
have other attorneys.
I have
Interesting.
two other attorneys, but then you also have to, when you're interviewing attorneys, you have to pay consultation fees. I mean, because you can't
Sure.
just go in and say, you're my attorney, this is going to
Sure.
work. No, you have to go through the process of interviewing attorneys and, finding who fits you best. So, I mean, there's consultation fees involved. They had appointments where they were setting me up for psych evals and IQ tests and language tests. And I mean, there's fees for that. I mean, there's literally like fees for everything.
Yeah, I would assume that there are fees, especially when you're dealing with legal, So where do you and your attorney stand now?
I have retained a new attorney who is ready to step in and basically reopen the negotiations because I understand that the type of deal that I got does not happen for everyone. And it's not the deal itself that caused me concerned. It was the terms of the trust account. For example, there's nothing written into the trust where if one of my children decide not to go to college, there's nothing that says where their money goes. So in essence, if one of them decide not to go to college, their money sits. How does that help
Interesting.
them? How does that benefit them? We didn't go through all of this for your money to be sitting there and for you not to be able to touch it. I want you to be able to take it, enjoy life, build a business, travel the world, do whatever you choose to do at that point because it came off my back for you to be able to get that.
That makes sense. I mean, that makes sense. I don't, like I said, the media reports what they want to report. However they want to spin a story, they can spin a story.
They
So I
absolutely
totally
do.
get it. Yeah. Now, there was, okay, so you have a new attorney, but this one I guess is not pro bono.
He is not. No.
Okay. So now we have three attorneys that have to be paid.
Now we have three attorneys to be
Okay.
paid.
All right. I just want to set it straight for people so they can know exactly what is happening. Now, the other thing I want to talk about is I've put the link for your donations, donate to your legal fees, and With that link, when people click on it, they can basically read somewhat of your story in terms of what is actually happening with the money, how much, expenses you have throughout the month, from how much the site took to how much you pay, a month. I think I read that you obtained a house, for you and the kids, and there's money that has to go. You have to pay for like different appointments and things like that. The lawyer fees can be anywhere between $800 to $1,200 a month, and so on and so forth. And I urge people that if they wanted to know where this money was going, they can read it there on your donation site, Donate to Legal Issues. And I put the link on my website so people can go and they can see that. It's also on my Facebook page as well as my Twitter page. But some people are asking the question that, okay, we get the fact that if you put the money away now, how does that help your immediate need? But some people are asking if you knew that there was 60,000 that had to be put aside, why not first put that aside so that you can make sure you fulfill the plea agreement. What do you
Well,
say
the
to
thing
those
about it
folks?
was the initial amount wasn't 60,000. The
Okay.
initial amount was only the 30,000 that was being negotiated.
Okay.
Later down the line, about September-ish, is when the 60,000 was revealed. Okay.
Okay.
I don't have a problem with the 60,000. I gladly hand over 60,000 to my children. Thing is, I want to be able to maintain them.
Right.
Giving the 60,000 now, with income coming in, only money going out, that puts us in a situation where we income within a couple months. Now, being that there's so much notoriety around me right now, being that, people are reluctant to take that chance because they just said they don't want to walk outside of work one day and see the news camera sitting in front of their place of
Sure.
employment. I've literally had people tell me this. I just don't
Sure.
want that exposure. Not that I would, bring that kind of exposure, but just simply because what I do is so monitored, they don't want that kind of exposure on their business. I've interviewed with countless people and they say, "You're a great person. I don't want to be attached to this stuff." So, with all this stuff going out, nothing coming in, knowing that I'm going to be tied up in court for the next 6 months to a year, I have to prepare myself for the long haul. I have to prepare
Right.
myself that I may only be able to work part time, if I can find a part time, for the next couple of months until I can get this entire thing resolved. So, knowing that, there was initially no time frame for me to put the money away. It just October 13th was their giving a deadline for me to put the money away. So
Wow.
the only thing that I've asked since that time is allow me the time to get us stable. I will gladly hand it over. I will gladly abide by what you want me to do, but allow me the time to get us stable so that it won't come February and I don't have any money left because I've been paying everything out for the last few months and now I have nothing. How do I benefit my children if I have nothing, and now I have no even signs of support to get anything for them?
Now, if you can, maybe do break down briefly, like I said, on your website, people can find exactly where the money go to. But now I'm assuming with an additional attorney that has to be paid and just the back and forth, maybe you can break down for people how the 14,000 was spent, because I had it up, I had the picture up in terms of, like I said, the media will have you believe what you want to believe, but let me put this picture back up for people to see how, or to see what the media is saying. There was $114,000 raised. The judge ordered the 60,000 for the, the children's trust, and you countered off with the 35. And so there's a question mark with, well, what has already been spent? And so I think that it would be a good idea to let people know that, what your living situation is, right? And possibly you break it down a little bit on your website, in terms of what your monthly bills look like. But maybe people need to hear it out your mouth, because I guess people are truly thinking that this money was squandered. And we have one person, Reverend Jared. Jared Mufin, however you pronounce his last name, which we'll talk about in a minute, who's, you know, coming out and saying that he was part of your camp and he knows for a fact that you spent money on jeans, shoes, and designer's bags and stuff like that, among other things that he said. But we're going to talk about him in a minute. But before we even get to him, kind of break down for people what you are facing, because people are truly believing that you just blew $114,000 and there's nothing to show for it.
No, I haven't blown it. I haven't blown it at all. My life has not changed very much. The only difference is I can afford my rent and utilities now.
Okay.
I spend money monthly basis on regular bills, you know, rent, utilities, transportation, food, you know, entertainment. We go to Chuck E. Cheese, we go to McDonald's, you know, regular life. Outside of that, I pay my attorneys. I pay for my parenting classes twice a week. I take my daughter to Tumblr's class. I take my son to soccer camp. You know, that's it. You know, I go and I do parties at the daycare. I volunteer in my daughter's class. I mean, I'm not living a lavish life, because this money was not given to maintain me. It was given to maintain them. So if it's not to their benefit, then I'm not spending it. That's like, I had to go on Facebook the other day because the comment was, oh, she's spending her money on Michael Kors bags.
Right.
No, it's a $20 Anne Klein from Ross, and it doubles as a diaper bag.
See that? You see that, folks? You just need the whole story. You know, I'm just, you know, again, people might say, well, Shay, you don't live with her. You don't know if she's telling the truth. All I know is that there's two sides to a story, and you can't always believe what the media is putting out there, because they're only putting out what they want to put out, and you have to be able to hear the other side of the story. And so, you know, I welcomed you coming back to the show, because it's like, well, what do you have to say about all of that? Now, let's get to this Reverend Jared Mufin. Is that how you pronounce his name?
Mufin. I'm actually interested in hearing, because I haven't heard these stories.
Okay,
so
I'm
interested in hearing this.
He, you know, I posted our interview on my YouTube channel, and apparently someone posted, for part one, someone posted a comment and says that he said all of these, said that the money is gone and you spent it on X, Y, and Z, and then he left a link for people to go and listen to what this man had to say. And he had a lot to say. He had it. He had a lot to say. I'm surprised you haven't heard about it, but he had a lot to say. I will forward it to you.
Yes, please.
I don't want to try to play it because, again, like I said, I'm not a technician and I've been on done something wrong while we on the air. So I don't want to play it, but you can go to my YouTube channel and look at the part one of the interview. And in the comment section, you'll see what this man, the link that he put in. And then this guy, you'll go to the link and you'll hear him. He's on a radio station and he's basically saying that the money is 100% gone, that he has been part of your camp, which I believe in some of the pictures on the news, we see him in the background standing behind you and the lawyer.
He was early in the process. Yes.
Okay. Early in the process, he was part of it, but he's claiming that the money is gone, that you, did not adhere to, I guess, your lawyer's advice, that initially it was supposed to be 60. They wanted to offer 45, meaning your attorney, your legal counsel, wanted to order 45,000 to be put into a trust. And then when y'all got in court, you all of a sudden decided, no, let it be 35,000. But then outside of that, he also mentioned that the money is 100% gone and it was spent on designer bags, designer shoes, designer jeans, and also to fund your children's father hip hop career and studio time. Yeah, that is what
ludicrous
has been put out there.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. So let me go in order.
Okay.
Okay. Jared Mopin was a part of the process in the beginning. He is someone associated with my attorney, who is an activist here in the Valley. My first time meeting him was through this case. So prior to this situation, I didn't know of him at all.
Okay.
Wow. The money has not been spent. It is not all gone, and it definitely has not been spent on designer bags, designer shoes, or designer anything, because I don't have anything designer, just simply because those types of things aren't important to me. What's important to me is making sure that there's a roof over my children's head, that they have food on their table and clothes on their back. I'm not worried about trying to flash or show or any of the above. In terms of funding my children's father's hip hop career, I don't know that he has a hip hop career. And if he does, it has nothing to do with me, nor would I take money out of my children's account to pay for his hip hop career. That is his own doing. My children's father is here for his children. He's here when I drop them off at school in the morning to care. And honestly, I can say that he's been a really stand-up guy through this process because a lot of the time, I don't have anybody to go around with me. I don't have anybody to do these things with me. And he's been that person. Regardless of whatever our situation was before this, he has stepped up to be that support system. When I need to go to court, when I need to walk with somebody, when I need to cry, he's here for those moments. He doesn't ask me for anything. I don't give him anything. If, in fact, I think he takes the bus here every day. So he's not benefiting from this situation in any way other than to be here for me and to be here for his children. He's here when, in the morning when I drop them off at school. He takes me around for whatever appointments I have to take care of. Well, lately he's gone back to work, so I've seen him a little bit less lately.
Okay,
But
he's back to work because that was another thing that Amanda Bishop had said. You shared with her that he is back in your life, but that he's not working.
right, no, he is back to, that's what I mean. But the problem is everybody is listening to the news and not enough people are asking me. When truly they have the connection to ask me, they're not taking the effort to say, hey, what's going on? And I feel like if you've done something for me as great as this, I owe you an explanation. I owe you enough to say, hey, this is what it is. So don't, you don't have to sit. And I mean, I think that's kind of the discord that's between me and Amanda right now, because she's hearing all this crazy stuff in the media too, and she's thinking, well, what's going on? And I don't know. And it's coming down on her. And I mean, I know it's a lot of stress and it's a lot of pressure because I live it every day. But ask me. I've kept an open communication, an open line, open everything with her from the beginning, because you cannot do something this great for someone and have them not feel some sort of affinity to you. That I would be a cold-hearted person if I did not have love for someone who could do something like this.
Wow, so then the relationship between you and Amanda, it's a little strained right now.
It's a little strained. She's receiving a lot of pressure, a lot of but I mean, I told her do what's best for you in the situation because I know what I have and I have not done. So in the end, that's not my word. That's not my.
So to let the record be, what do they say in those courts? Let the record show, I guess. The money is not gone. It wasn't spent on designer bags. You didn't fund your children's father hip hop career. He doesn't even have a hip hop career. He's back to work. And so that's what it is concerning that. So all of what Reverend Muffin was saying, just not true.
It's not true at all. And I think it's laughable that he would speak up on those types of things, because he kind of disappeared after I decided not to fund his congressional campaign.
I was gonna
So,
ask you what's his reason for going out there and saying this, because when I heard it and I did some research to find out who he was, I said, okay, he must have asked for some money, and she said no.
exactly. Yeah,
Got you.
that's what happened there. So I think it's funny that he has, so much to say. Oh, and going back to another point where he said that my lawyers wanted to offer 45,000. The 45,000 was actually my idea. They told me to go less than that so that there would be negotiation room between the 35 and the 60.
I see.
So he twisted that story completely. And why he would know that is another reason that I've released my attorney, because that was a conversation between only me and my attorney. So why does he have that kind of information?
And I think one of the guys who was interviewing him, and he's a regular on the show, on that show that he was on, they had said what would be the recommendation, and he said that he recommended that your lawyer would quit because I guess you just weren't cooperating or something like that. So, okay, we don't need to spend no more time on Reverend Jarrett. We get it. Now, As far as Amanda Bishop, I just want to mention one more thing with her. She mentioned that during the time of everything when it first happened, she was forwarding you job interviews and stuff like that, or job postings that people were willing to hire you for, and she doesn't know like where what happened with that. Can you address that?
I didn't receive anything directly from her. So if she sent those, she may have sent those through my attorney. Since October 13th, my attorney has, excuse me, former attorney, I have to make sure I'm saying that properly. My former attorney has been sending me job links since October 13th. I have followed up on every link that I've been sent just simply because it's kind of like, when you have everything against you, you want to try everything and see what works out. A lot of them have not worked out simply because scheduling. I'm on a very strict schedule right now. I have to make sure that whatever job I accept is going to fit in 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. because those are my daycare hours. I can't do weekends at this moment just simply because I can't guarantee that I'll have a sitter every weekend. And I can't roll the dice and say, okay, well, I think I will. There's no think, maybe, possible. No, I have to be definite that I can be there to at least get through that first 90 days because that's your probationary period. They want to know that you can commit that first 90 days. So, a lot of it is scheduling right now. Actually, primarily, it's either scheduling, the pay. You know, some of the jobs they want you to work for commission only. I can't quite do commission right now. I need to know that I have a set amount coming every month so I can schedule to make sure, you know, bills, rent, utilities are taken care of.
That makes sense.
The other portion is just simply, you know, them not wanting to be associated with the things that I have going on. So, I mean, I've had offers, but in terms of those offers being able to fit what I have going on right now, especially knowing that, you know, once a month, twice a month, I'm gonna have to, you know, break away to go to court, and you just can't, you can't come into a job with those kind of requirements because they don't want to hear that. They don't want to hear, oh, I need a day off because I need to go to my parenting class. Oh, I need the afternoon off because I need to go to a psych eval. Oh, wait, now I need a day off because I need to go to court. That's not gonna work.
Employees are just not willing to. I mean, they are sympathetic, but it's like they still have a business to run.
Exactly.
So, yeah,
And they
that's
can't seem
real.
like they're being lenient to you and not to others. You have to come in and fall in line and do what everybody else is doing, regardless of what's happening outside of work.
Two other things. As far as in the news, they said that they're postponing to another date, and in that time, you need to bring in bank statements, and that there was the thing where the money was placed into your mother's account. Can you speak about that?
The mother, excuse me, the money was initially placed into my mother's account, and that's simply because I didn't have an account at that time. So that's where it remains, just because that's, you know, my mother's actually a safe person. Everybody wants to believe, you know, she's terrible and she's gonna spend it through. No, my mother's more frugal than I am. So it's just it's sitting, waiting for me to be able to reach the terms that are going to, you know, help us now as well as in the future. In terms of them asking for bank statements, that's not true. There was a motion that was filed with the court to request the bank statements, but no other case like this have they been able to request financial information. So the judge did turn that motion down. And I mean, that's something that I don't agree with anyway, because my finances are my business. And what they want to know is how much I have, basically, so they can tie it all up. They want to know how much I have so they can allot this amount to go here, this amount to go there, this amount to go there, this amount to go there, when that wasn't the purpose of this.
Interesting. I mean, yeah, and some folks who those that donated, I think it was over 4,000 people, some of them are saying, well, she should show folks where everything has gone, especially, you know, since the media is saying that it was squandered and it's no more, and so she needs to account for all of it. But I guess your stance is that, you know, that is your business. Thank you guys for raising the money. I definitely appreciate it. But to tie it all up, that's not helping me. It's basically putting me back in the situation that I was in.
And that's their intention, is to tie it up. It's not to show people where the money is gone. It's to say how much is there, so we can say you need to take care of this, you need to pay for that, you need to take care of that, you need to do that. It's not to show anyone anything in this particular case.
Okay. As far as these felony charges, they said that they were reinstated. Is that the truth, or are you guys still negotiating?
At this point, I can't really tell you what is going on
Okay.
because what I understood is when we left court on Monday the 27th that we were still in negotiations.
Okay.
I received an email later that afternoon that we had reached different terms, and those were the terms we were going to put on the record. I saw on the news later that evening that they had decided to refile the charges. So at this point, I had to go back to my attorney, like, okay, are we negotiating or are they filing the charges? What is happening at this point? So he just kind of left it very vague, and that wasn't good for me because, going through all these situations, where here you have people giving out information that was discussed between you and I, and I mean, that's not the first time that situation has happened. So that kind of led up to me saying, I need somebody who's going to fight this fight because they're going to bring everything that they have. So I need someone who is going to bring everything that they have to this fight, and hopefully I will come out okay. That's all I keep saying is I want to come out of this situation okay. I understand I may not be great. I don't want to be on the bottom. I just want to be okay.
Okay, that's fair enough. So we don't know where it stands as far as this whole felony charges being reinstated. We're just not sure.
I can't tell you for sure that the
Okay.
news is reporting they've been refiled. I find out tomorrow the status of what's actually happening.
Okay. Is there anything else you want the folks to know?
Phew. I just, I'd like everyone to basically know that I'm a real person. I'm not, this monster that they keep painting me to be in the media. I'm not someone out just squandering my money away, spending it on frivolous things. I'm not. Every dollar that I've spent has been for my children's well-being. Everything that I've taken care of is for their well-being. If it's not for them, then there's no point in me doing it, which is the whole point of me going through this process anyway. If it's not going to better their situation, if it's not going to keep them healthy and happy through life, then it's not worth my effort. And that's how I live my life.
And then to the four, over 4,000 folks who donated, who might now be, on the fence and not sure what's happening, what do you want to say to those folks?
I apologize to those people because they came into this with good intentions. They were trying to help a family, and that's kind of, turned against them. I mean, I just want them to know that what you donated has gone to help my children. It has given them back a life. They have clothes that fit now. They have shoes that fit now. They eat dinner every night. They wake up every morning in their own beds. What you intended to do has been done. So
Good.
I understand that the media is twisting things and making it seem as if I'm this terrible person, but I'm not.
Good.
I'm the same person who was in a terrible situation, who has improved that situation through the generosity of you, and I will continue to fight this fight. I will continue to stay in this to say I'm not who they say that I am. And in the end, it's going to come out that, hey, she really was doing what she was supposed to do. And that's okay for me. You have to go through the muck sometimes in order to get to, the good stuff. So I'm just in the muck right now, and that's okay.
Okay. Well, good. I mean, I appreciate you taking the time to call in. I know you mentioned that no one has asked you anything. They're just going off of what they hear in the media. And so I'm glad that I have given you this opportunity to set the record straight because, again, the media will have you believe what it wants you to believe. And you need to kind of hear the whole thing. And so I'm glad that you said that to those that, supported you and donated their five, 10, 100, whatever they donated, because they needed to know that this is not what's going on, and here's the real. So I appreciate you for calling in. You are, like I said, a friend of Spiritual Sense with Shay. And so if you ever need to call in again to kind of set the record straight, because I would assume that this is not going to be over anytime soon, and we'll continue to hear just the updates from the media standpoint. And so I think that You're not going to be able to please everybody, even those that supported you. Some of them have already switched to the other side, and some of them may just believe that you are doing something else with the money and just will not believe that you are doing what you have to do. And, you know, don't get caught up with the I have to explain everything, because there's always going to be something to be said. You're doing right by your kids. The goal is to get all of this court stuff finished so you could just live your life with your kids and do what you have to do, and perhaps maybe even move out of the place, because, you know, you just want to be able to start somewhere fresh and clean without, like you said, news reporters waiting for you outside your job. So,
and I just want to be able to walk through Walmart without people saying, don't I know you? Yeah. No, no.
Just a normal normal life. Like, I'm just coming to Walmart to get me a pair of socks. That's it. Like, you don't know me. It's fine. Like,
I just want to get my milk and my bread, and I want to go about my business.
That's it. I hear that. Well, Shanisha, thank you so much again for calling in. It's been great talking with you. Thank you for setting the record straight. It was very important for me to have you do that. So thank you for that. And if there's nothing else, we will talk again sometime soon.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Okay. Bye. Okay, folks. So you heard it. That. I'm sorry. My mic keeps doing something crazy. But nevertheless, thank you so much, folks. That was Shanisha Taylor. Again, setting the record straight. Again, if you have been listening to the media, you have just heard it from her, you know, out of her mouth in terms of what she's actually been dealing with. And so I hope that that helps a lot of people to just know that it's a single mother trying to do what she needs to do for her kids. That's it. That's all. She might not be able to wrap it in a pretty red bow, but nevertheless, she's trying to make things happen for her family. And that's all that you have here. So.